good afternoon, good afternoon, good afternoon again. Good afternoon, dear citizen of the Berge, Eastern Cape, South Africa, and abroad. It is me, Unwabisa Mbekela, once again with the afternoon talk at Okapi FM, bringing the gospel nearer to you. As you know that we're always bringing you movers and shakers of the Berge. We bring you business people within the Eastern Cape, and we also bring you business people of South Africa. Allow me to welcome you today to the afternoon talk with Unwabisa Mbekela from Agape FM as I introduce you to Mr. Casper Lagrange. How are you, sir?
I'm good, and you, Unwabisa?
I'm good. I'm always good. I am blessed. This is Casper. Is it fine if I call you Casper?
That's 100%.
We're sitting with Casper from the Debt Counseling Group of South Africa. They are leading.
Yes,
they are leading at number one. So, congratulations. And they have been keeping at it. And thank you so much for coming. Thank you.
It's only a pleasure. You know, it's always nice to be invited locally. Keep things local. Keep things blessed in our province. And keeping positive. There's always positive news. And it's so good to be here and to have some positive news to your listeners.
And let me just say, I'm so excited to be talking to you today, because it is one thing that as much as we are living in this COVID life right now, but we are living in a generation that we make dates.
Yes.
And we make dates, so it's like a lifestyle.
We want everything now.
Exactly.
We're living in the moment.
Exactly.
I want that new phone today, not tomorrow. Look at my neighbor. He's driving a nice fancy car. Why can't I? Can I afford it? And how do you know if you can afford it?
Yeah. So I'm so excited to be talking to you today. And I'm so excited for everyone who's joined in. And I'm so excited to be here. Let me just say, it is a good Monday today. I feel blessed. I feel excited. But let me just say that if you're tuning in now, please grab that pen. Please grab that notepad, because I did mention earlier on that it's about to get heated and it's about to get real in here. Reading the bio, as we always do, debt counseling is a voluntary process created by government in the National Credit Act 34 of 2005 to assist or enable over-indebted citizens. Looking for assistance with your debt? Do not be ashamed to take the first step and ask for help with your debt. With the current economy and regular increase of cost of basic needs, people are more and more in debt and in need for help. Most people are too proud to ask for assistance before it is too late. If you feel you are in need for help, or creditors are phoning you frequently asking when you're making your next payment, and you need to be realistic and take the first step in getting help. Benefits of debt counseling are: tailored payment structure to suit your individual need, one affordable monthly installments reduced by up to 50%. Installments introduced by up to 50%. Have sufficient funds for living expenses. Credit providers must communicate with your debt counselor, not you. You will be legally protected against your creditors. DCGSA can assist you no matter where you are in South Africa. They have an office in East London, the Berge, King Williamstown, and Queenstown. Sir, what you're doing is amazing. It is amazing. I'm seeing a few people who joined in on our live. Do you have anyone that you want to send a shout out to?
Oh, well, to the whole Kabeja,
Or
also known as Port Elizabeth. I think there's still a lot of chat about where we're going, and the whole Eastern Cape. You know, we're a vibrant province. We've got a lot of big names coming from this wonderful province. And we must keep it up, and we must uplift each other and bring each other together. Don't go support out-of-town people. Support local. Support the Eastern Cape. And, you know, we've got the best names here. We've got the best people here. So let's go back to our roots and help each other out of our debts. We help each other knowing how to move forward, how to put a budget together, and help your neighbor. You know, we tend to talk a lot, but if somebody comes to you with a problem, that is us as Eastern Cape people. We talk to each other, say, yo, you know, I don't know. But where's that advice then? Where's that help then coming from? So, yo, just a shout out to everybody. And stay positive and stay uplifting each other.
Stay uplifting each other. And remain in the Eastern Cape. Make it local. Remain local. There's assistance everywhere. And what I love about it, PE or Eastern Cape, is that we're a nation on our own. We have so many resources within Eastern Cape. And it just takes you to just help or ask for help and help one another. So thank you so much for that. Going into the interview, I did mention that I'm so excited. Let me just say, I'm so excited. As one person, I think I am 0.001 within the youth of South Africa as a whole, who is interested in debt counseling and want to know more about what is debt counseling and how we can help one another within debt. Because let me just say, we are a generation that just falls into debt because we are in competition with the next. So how long have you been a debt counselor?
Well, I actually started as a debt counselor back in 2009. Now, to give you a bigger picture of where that is in the debt counseling realm, the National Credit Act only came about in 2007. Well, it was implemented in July of 2007, and I became a debt counselor in 2009. So with that being said, I first had a few franchises, and in 2011 I said, no, I need to do this. I need to help my people. I need to do this and create our own brand. So Debt Counseling Group South Africa was born in 2011, 5th of March. And we've been in the Eastern Cape for the last 10 years. So that is where I, as a debt counselor, came into this wonderful industry. But it has changed magnificently over time. And we actually see the banks really saying, listen here, go to a debt counselor. They can assist you. Where we can't assist you anymore. Yes, we'll give you another loan, but up until a point. And we're very well regulated now in the industry, which is wonderful. But making sure you go to a debt counselor that understands your needs.
True. And you also mentioned that you offer tailored services. So it's one thing to go to a person and ask for help and they give you what the other person that they helped helped them, but for you it's not tailored. So thank you. We needed that. So you also mentioned that you opened a few franchises before this. Briefly tell me more about what did you do before you became a debt counselor?
Well, I studied. I actually went to school here in Gqeberha. I matriculated here. And then I went to study at Stellenbosch and did BCom Law over there. And then I said, okay, well, what do I need to do with my life? I had a company called Save Energy. And then I thought, okay, well, I love helping people. I've got my legal and accounting background. And it's really nice to help people. It's in my nature. I'm a friendly person. I'm an outgoing person. I can't just sit in the corner and be on my own. I need to see people. So you can imagine how tough COVID's been for me. So dealing with people has really been the love. And this process has enabled me to help people, to give my knowledge, to give my legal into it, and to say, listen here, you don't have to lose your house. You don't have to lose your car. So I think really, to be honest, debt counseling was created for me. And then I just took it by the horns and say, listen here, this suits me. I love helping people. I love the Eastern Cape. So let's get it going here. So that is where I came from. And I'm here now. And then in 2009, like I said, I moved to East London actually to open an office there. And I was only going to be there a year and move back to Cape Town. And then life swallowed me in. And in 2011, I opened DCGSA. And now I'm happily married and got dogs, got kids, got the whole thing. And just happy, just boiling out of my element in this process and helping people. You know, it's such a joy to see where you've taken a family where they couldn't even put bread on the table. Mm. And they're earning these big salaries, but they've got nothing to show for it. People losing their houses and cars and saying, well, I can actually help you. Mm. And this process works. And like you rightfully said earlier, tailor-made process. Not giving a consumer a quote, but actually assisting them with their budget, putting a plan in place, and helping them understand how to budget, how to plan. So when they're done with us, they're on their own feet. They can buy that house they dreamed of. They can buy that car that they dreamed of. Mm. And that is so wonderful about this great process.
You see, dear listener, why I was so excited? I mean, I love the fact that you're mentioning all these things, and I'm getting goosebumps, because it's one thing to help someone, and it's one thing to help someone with passion. Because you're very passionate about this thing, because you love people and you love this. So tell me why become a debt counselor?
Oh, like I said, my background in the legal, and then Save Energy, I was the chief financial officer. I've got the legal and financial backing. I've got the understanding of what people need and how the finances go about. So why debt counseling? Like I said, it was created for me.
Yes.
Yes, it only came about in 2007, but I think it knew when I was born. Listen, yeah. This is a thing. This is me. This is Casper LaGrange. This is DCGSA. And you know, the nicest thing is our whole team at DCGSA have this passion to help people. Mm. I mean, from our head consultant to reception to all our different offices, everybody I can truly say love helping people. Yeah. And it's, they've seen it work for so many people. And they say, well, how can they do anything else once they've seen that they can actually help people? They can go to bed at night and say, yo, I've saved people. I've been able to help people feed their kids. I've been able to help people keep their car. Mm. So it's such a nice process. And yes, to earn your living from that, it's a joy.
Nicely said. It was created for you. It was made for you. And you just walked into it right there. Mm. Oh, I love that. I love that. Let me just walk into my purpose. Because you are doing your purpose. You're doing what you love. And I love that. And continue doing that. You also mentioned that you were from Iqebera. You studied here. And you went to East London.
Yes.
The plan was just for a year.
Yes.
But it just became home, and now there's a family in there. That's how we are in the East Cape. You can't go. We are so welcoming. So in what areas of South Africa do you operate in?
Well, we can assist all of South Africa.
Mm.
You know, with this day and age, you know, if I can tell you a background story, I love stories of things that happened. And we opened in East London and King Williamstown and Queenstown and Kebecha. And then we started getting phone calls. I said, listen, yeah, my family member's with you. I know I'm not from East London or from Kebecha, but I'm in Pretoria. And actually, one of our first clients was a family member of East London, and said, no, they've dealt with all these call center people and these other places, but they've seen how we've helped their family. They want to come to us. And so it started to snowball. And we've put in systems in place where we can actually assist people right across South Africa. But we're not a call center setup. So don't expect you're going to phone and get a quote. I'm not about quotes. We're there to assist the consumer, putting a budget in place, tell them, listen, this is how it works, explaining that process. And only once you've got a plan and you're happy with the plan we're going to put in place and you understand the process, this process isn't just, yes, I'm going to give my things to a debt counselor, they're going to sort out all my debt. No, it is something we need to walk with each and every consumer of ours and put them in a position where they can afford to live and pay back their debt in a reasonable period. And also not for that consumer that just wants to run away from their debt. They want to make a commitment, say, listen, I want to pay my debt. I can't afford it. Please help me. I'm committed to this. And those consumers, I can truly tell you, they get out the other side and say, well, I mean, just go look at our Google reviews. Our consumers are proud to say, and it's tough to say, listen, yeah, I had a problem, But now I'm done with my problem, and these are the people that assisted me. So doing it right from the get-go really helps put those consumers back on track.
It's a story. And it's always positive, because I also did my and these days we call it stalking, but I was doing my research. And I saw the reviews, because that's the first thing, especially for a business. I always go for the reviews just to see what are you up to, what do you do, and from whatever that you're doing, then I'll go on your nice page and everything else. You see, because the story is in the reviews.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for doing such a wonderful job.
It's only
thank
pleasure.
You so much. So you operate wherever, you take clients wherever in South Africa,
but especially here where we have offices, Gqeberha, East London, Queenstown, King Williamstown, Mthatha. You can come and see us. We know how the Eastern Cape operates. We still in the Eastern Cape do the face to face thing. Cape Town, Durban, Joburg, they want to do the online thing, but it doesn't put you away that you can't do it online. You're welcome to, but you've got a place to go to.
Citizens of Eastern Cape, if you are struggling with your debt, if you need help, it's okay to say I need help. And let me just say that there are debt counselors within the Eastern Cape who are willing to help you. Let me just say the DCGSA is right here to offer tailored support and to offer you great support. Do you have a small, medium, or large debtors counseling company?
Well, we are actually voted as the number one large debt counsel in South Africa, but we still operate on the boutique level, in the sense where yes, we've got thousands of clients, and yes, we've got a good legal backing to assist you through this process. But when you're one of our clients, you know the people at offices. You know, I'm going to speak to Nangamso, I'm going to speak to a Laverne, I'm going to speak to Alicia, I'm going to speak to Dasneem. They don't just disappear. You've got somebody to talk to. I know most, if not all, of my consumers. I might not know where they live. I might not know that, but I know their debt. I know their income. I know their stories. And at some point, I have spoken to each of my clients. And that is what makes us, yes, we're a large debt counseling firm, but we still operate at a boutique level where you get to speak to the people. You don't deal with these big call centers and you've got no clue who works there or whatever. So,
And that's very important, because if you know who you're talking to, it's very easy to form that relationship with them and trust with them, because this is money that we're talking about, as much as it's debt, but you need to form trust. And I love the fact that you guys also offer the boutique services. You are operating at a boutique level as much as you're number one, but you are doing this, and I love that it forms relationships with. So now you are number one. This is success. But how do you make, what makes your success or your business successful?
I believe it's our passion. You've lived my passion. You've met me as a person. And I must say, each one of our team have this passion. We have this passion to help. We know how the process goes. Our girls go through rigorous training that they know and understand the full process. And dealing then with credit providers, when once you have the knowledge, we can get the best for our consumer. And understanding the process, we can explain the process to the consumer the best. And what makes us the best is we don't quote a consumer. We help a consumer. But we tell them from the get-go, if you're not going to do this process with us, don't do it. But once you've decided you're going to do this, we need to do it together to the very end. Do your yearly checkups. Yes, maybe you everything is going smoothly. You don't hear from us. Come pop in. Give us a phone call. Pop us an email. See how things are going. We're going to send you SMSs, send you emails. We don't want to be in your face all the time. But when you need us, we will be there. And I believe that has proven to work. For the last 4 years, we've been in the top five in the country. And now eventually, through lockdown, through everything, being voted number one just shows you doing the right thing every time. It pays off in the long run, and it pays off for our consumers. So big thank you also for our consumers and our clients in Tribeca, and to those listening. Thank you for choosing us to be your number one debt counselor in South Africa.
Thank you, dear listener. Thank you, Tribeca Yenza. Thank you, Eastern Cape. Thank you so much for choosing to pay off your debts. And thank you so much for using DCGSA. I'm sorry about that. Thank you so much, because now it's that tailored relationship that gives clients wants to come and know that I can actually refer my friend. I can refer my friend, my family member to come, because I know they're struggling with debt. So it's that relationship that you guys form that make you the best in what you do. And thank you so much. Where do you find new business?
Well, I think our biggest base is our current consumers. Our current consumers, they refer their friends and family. I mean, colleagues speak to colleagues. That is our biggest base of new business. And then also, we do big education sessions like we're doing today, on radio, in the media, in your Herald, which is a local newspaper. And we tend to educate consumers. We don't necessarily do the marketing part, but educating consumers how things are supposed to work. And even if they were somebody else, listen, yeah, this is how it's supposed to work. You know, so many times we get consumers that come to us and we say, okay, well, let's just explain the process and see what you actually know. So education is key. Wellness is key. The consumer is key, and their education and taking them further in their knowledge and understanding of their finances is where our consumer base grows.
Nicely said. I will not top that anything up. I will not say anything further, but I'll have a question. Who are your most cooperative?
Our most cooperative? Well, we assist everywhere. Government, private sector. We recently assisted Johnson & Johnson with their wellness internally. I know government departments are currently not doing all their wellnesses, but we assist Labor Department, Health Department, all of that, and your local municipalities with their wellness. Because at the end of the day, you've got a consumer. On payday, they're not at work. Why are they not at work? They're going to go borrow because their salary was gone after all the debit orders go off. They stress. They don't know where their money is going to come from. So we assist right through. As long as you've got an income, you want to pay your debt, we can assist you. If you are an employer and you see your staff struggling, we offer those wellness programs, those budget trainings for free. So you contact us. You say, listen, yeah, my staff needs assistance. They need guidance. We will offer that for free for 10 or more employees normally. We do a nice session. So corporate, government level, any consumer that's got an income or any employer that's got staff that they can see they need assistance. We know the last 2 years were terrible. Finance has gone through, and we're around the corner, you know. Black Friday, then Christmas, then it's the long 4 months of January before you get your salary. And people tend to want to just forget about their debt. You know, we become ostriches. We put our head in the sand and we don't know what's happening because we're scared. So, yeah, we service commercial, the private sector, government sector, anybody that needs our services. We welcome them with open arms.
With every business, there's always challenges. We face challenges on a daily basis. Yes, you might be number one, but there are always challenges.
Definitely.
And there are always challenges. So, in your own words, how would you say what is the biggest challenge facing debt counselors at the moment with COVID happening?
I think biggest challenges facing debt counselors is definitely consumers not communicating. Because we can only do so much with what we know, what we see. Remember, debt counselor doesn't receive the money. It goes through a payment distributing agent. and we see the money not coming in, we try and contact that consumer, they just disappear off the face of the earth. So that is a problem. You must always communicate with your debt counselor immediately.
Mm.
Then obviously dealing with the corporates, dealing with the credit providers,
mm.
where now suddenly their staff are working from home and cell phones aren't working, yeah. and telephones not mm. working, and we're trying to sort out a consumer situation. So that's a big challenge. We see the smaller debt counselors close down. We see the big call center debt counselors not mm. answering their phones and helping their current consumers. So there's always problems. There's always a mountain. But at DCGSA, and you'll see if you Google us as well, solutions.
Mm.
And we always try and seek a solution. Yes, it might not be an overnight solution, but we will not stop until we find that solution for our consumers. So yes, there's challenges, but we'll find the solution. And I think for debt counseling in general, we'll probably see a peak in the early new year as people have now grabbed for loans and debt to try and help them through this time period.
True. You're speaking mostly on consumers.
Yes.
Not communicating and everything else. So what is the biggest challenge that your consumers are facing at the moment?
Our consumers are definitely, not now per se, but I think over the COVID period, if we look at the last 19, 20 months, pay cuts, medical bills, people losing their jobs. We saw thousands, hundreds of thousands of consumers losing their jobs that can't make their payments anymore. That's already got great relief through this process, but now suddenly they've lost another income and we can't really assist that consumer. So we've looked at, once again, finding solutions.
Mm.
So we've also joint forces with other companies that give income protectors, that give credit life for our consumers. So if a COVID happens or if you do lose your job going forward, we don't have the problem over the last 20 months again. We make sure that they've got credit life in place. So if they do lose their job, their debt is paid for a time period. That they do have income protector for in case we lose our job. You know, we in the Eastern Cape, we tend to grab for a funeral cover. But what if I don't have a job anymore? What then? Where's my income? How am I going to support my family members I've been supporting with my income? So those are things that we looked at and we said, okay, what is the solution? Let's get our consumers income protectors. Let's get them credit life for their debt. So if something happens, if they lose their job, if they unfortunately pass away, their debt are covered. Their income is covered. And it's not that expensive. So consumers can approach us for that. Even if you're not under debt review, we can look at your situation. And that's what's so beautiful about DCGSA. When we do an assessment, it's obligation-free. Doesn't sign a consumer up for anything. But we can look at little things like that. Do you have an income protector? Do you have credit life on your debt in case you lose your job? In case your spouse loses their job or in case somebody passes away in the family, what are you going to do then? Don't just look at, okay, but if I pass, what then? What if you just lose your income? So we look at those solutions. And like I say, we're solution finders. We're going to find a solution for your unique situation. But I cannot help you if I don't know you. So make a point of it and come and see us. Even if you don't have problems with your debt now, maybe you need to look at what if. And we can look at that for you as well.
You also mentioned that even if a person is not under debt review, they can also come and just seek help and understanding and everything else. What advice would you have, or what advice do you have for customers who are already under debt review?
Well, if they're not under debt review with us, if they are with us, probably things are going good. If they're not with us and they need assistance, and I know there is quite a number of smaller guys that have closed down, big debt counselors they can't get in touch with, they must just give us a shout. Our assessments, like I said, is for free. It's obligation free. We can see what their situation is. Bring your debt review court order that you have with the other debt counselor, and we can look and guide you, not necessarily take you over from them, but just guide you on, this is what's supposed to happen. get in touch, or let's try and get you the numbers of that debt counselor that you can speak to them. So we're not there to shoot down other debt counselors, because lots of time the debt counselor does their job right, but the consumer doesn't understand or doesn't grasp the process. So we will explain that process to you and guide you in the right direction. They can also feel free to get in touch with us. Like I said, our arms are open. We're here for the Eastern Cape. We're here for Gqeberha. And if you need guidance, you need help, you've got a number.
Yeah, speak up. So I know for a fact that financial stress causes you not to be productive. And whenever you're stressed, your body just relapses. You can't do anything. What advice do you have for consumers with debt stress?
Well, I think definitely get an assessment done. Just like you would go to the doctor. You know, we found lots of consumers. I actually had a consumer came to us. She complained like every month for over the last year, she's been sick. She eventually approached us. She's been to the doctor, and then it's the flu, then it's that, then it's this. And like you rightfully said, that stress creates your body also to cave in and to now suddenly get sick all the time. So come and do an assessment. We see what your financial predicament is, and we find a solution. It might not be debt review. It might not be our process. Maybe you don't even understand debt review. And one can look at that. And like you rightfully say, we've actually assisted one government department, where they found that their staff aren't there during pay week. They can't find a solution to that. They've had psychiatrists, all of that in. And once we've assisted them with the debt part, people aren't off sick with not being there, not at work. They're no longer sick. They're actually healthy, because that stress is taken off of your shoulders. And stress has a big impact. I mean, we see how many divorces happening because husband and wife don't talk about the finances. Then they start fighting about little nitty-gritty things that's got nothing to do with anything. And they end up divorcing. And what's the actual problem? You know how many calls we get and say, listen, I wanna come and see you guys. I know I need you, but please don't tell my husband or wife. You know, and eventually you get both of them sitting there, and you can see the relief once they both spoke about their debt, and they realize, but they're both stressing about the same thing, you know. And then the fights end up a couple of years ago, or not 2-3 years ago, I had a couple fighting like cats and dogs in my office. We helped them, assisted them, you know. And it's an elderly couple. They're in their late 50s. And suddenly they came back after 3 months to fetch a copy of their court order, which we obtained for them to restructure their debt. And they were holding hands and lovey-dovey like young 16-year-olds. So it just shows you the stress and the conflict it creates. And now you take it out on your kids or on your spouse. So get it sorted. Get your budget in place. Maybe you don't need debt review. Maybe you just need guidance on what to do with your money. And that is what this wonderful process is all about, actually.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me just say that it has been a wonderful, wonderful past 34 minutes. And I still want to know more. I wish we could take this conversation further, because there are so many people out there who don't even know what debt review is. And they don't even know how to handle their finances. And let me just say that when it comes to money, when it comes to finances, it's a stress on its own. And now when there's debt in there, because we are not disciplined enough with debt and disciplined enough with finances, it becomes a frustration, and now we become stressed and we don't even come to work. So, dear listener, let me just say that DCGSA is here to help you, and they don't coach. They do not coach you. So please do come and please do ask for help. It is never too late. It is never too early to know where you're standing with your finances and with your debt. So yeah, we, when it comes, We always ask, because you've been given advice, but we always it's a tradition on the side, especially with the midday talk and the afternoon conversation, where we ask the guest to leave just a word of encouragement to someone who's out there, who's listening right now. They might be going on a debt review. They might not even know where they stand with debt. They might not even know how to handle their finances. They might be someone who's young like me and don't even know how to budget. No, because budgeting is very important, but they don't know how to budget. How would you encourage that person to go about their life?
Oh, understand a budget. And there's so many. You can just go to our website and go. We've got a little budget form, just a basic one. Just start with the basics. Know where your money is coming from and know where it is going. And don't plan for your wants. Save up for those. Plan for your needs. And what do I mean by that? Put aside what you need for groceries, for transport, for your basic everyday expenses. And before you just take out the credit card or just swipe at the teller for a new pair of shoes or a cell phone, or apply for a loan or a credit card, budget for it. Put money away for your wants and make sure you have enough for your needs.
Powerful. That is powerful. That is wise. That is everything. If you are like me and you're a shopper, let me just say, go into the website and just look at that that basic budget template, because we need it. I myself need it. I'm a shoe shopper. I go crazy when it comes to shoes. So if you're like me, as I am about to go in that website and that Facebook pages and just see and go budgeting and learn and understand what budgeting is. Well, maybe someone doesn't even know how to go into or where to go into, where to find you. Where are you on social media?
Social media, we are everywhere. I think if I can give the basic addresses. The first one would be our 086 number. It comes to us London and Tabega offices. It's 086-100-1047. Very simple. And then if you're sitting at work or you're sitting at home, you want to send an email, it's very easy. help@dcgsa.co.za. Or go to our website, www.dcgsa.co.za. Debt Counseling Group South Africa. And you'll find the links for our Facebook, or you can just Google it. I'm sure you'll find it. Very easy, Debt Counseling Group South Africa. And go look up a bit. And if you need advice on a budget, we freely give that.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is the afternoon talk session with me, Unobi Sambekela, at Akabi FM, where we bring you nothing but goodness and the gospel nearer to you. I am sitting with Casper Lagrange of Debt Counseling Group South Africa. And if you missed it, it will always be on our Facebook pages. And if you missed it again, it is on our website. And let me just say, please seek help today. And start now budgeting, and it's never too late to ask for help. So thank you so much, Casper, for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.
I hope this is not the last time we're seeing you.
Well, we'll hear from you.
Yes. we need this advice. We need everything from you, because I know that Kabeja as its own, we need people like you, and we need business like you. So thank you so much. Thank you so much. Dear listener, I am Unobi Sambekela. The time is 40 minutes past 3. It is a Monday afternoon, and it is not cold. It is not hot. But let me just say, it is 21 degrees Celsius of the weather, and I'm leaving you. I'm leaving you with Sinar Singh, Simply Devoted. This is Unobi Sambekela from Akabi FM, bringing the gospel nearer to you. Goodbye. Mm-hmm.